It was once just a theory, but today quantum computing is a reality. D-Wave, the company responsible for inventing the first commercial quantum computer, is helping Google, NASA, and Lockheed Martin to solve some of the world's most complex problems. It works 100 million times faster than a conventional computer at the coldest sustained temperature in the known universe, and scientists are only now learning how to harness its full potential. How does this machine work? And what kind of problems it's solving?
A quantum computer in general is a kind of computer that uses the rules of quantum mechanics to process information. It's very different from classical computers, which use simple mathematics that we can do easily in our heads, except it does those incredibly quickly. In quantum mechanics and quantum computing, you're using very, very different rules. So things like superposition and quantum tunneling and entanglement become tools with which you can solve problems. Initially, we were focused on optimization problems, like logistics, scheduling problems. What we're seeing as kind of the sweet spot of the technology, or what it's doing really well, is contributing to machine learning in a new kind of way and bringing some new resources to what's possible in the machine learning field. So this thing with the little chip at the center, which is smaller than your thumbnail, is the quantum processor. And that goes into a package that's cooled in a fridge to the coldest sustained temperature in the known universe. Temperature is like noise. And the colder we can get something, the lower that noise is, and the less it will interfere with the quantum mechanics.
What is the temperature you cool it down to?
So we cool it down to about 10 millikelvin, which is around 180 times colder than interstellar space.
You're considered to be the only company in the world who is selling quantum computers. Which organizations or which companies are using your computer today?
The University of Southern California is using it for mostly research purposes to train the next generation of scientists on quantum computing. Lockheed Martin is using it to make their software more reliable on F-35 airplanes. We did some work with Google, facial recognition issues, how to find a car in a scene. And so we did some early work with them on developing algorithms which could train their computer how to recognize a car. The machine that they bought is actually located at NASA Research Headquarters at Ames Air Force Base in California. All the research that NASA and Google and Facebook and all the people who are using machine learning, they are developing more and more sophisticated tools to make sure that the accuracy of what they're actually seeing improves as time goes on, as the machine learns. We have investments in the several small companies where we have given them access to our machine to develop applications in drug design and in financial technologies, where we own part of their company in exchange for free time on our machine. They can't afford to buy a $15 million machine, but if they want to come to us, we can tell them, hey, you know, we can make a deal.
Which areas quantum computing is going to impact in the future, you think?
Whether it's brain research or cancer research, understanding and being able to model and learn from various ways you might design a drug to address a particular cancer, this is going to be probably the most important application that you and I will benefit and notice. There isn't really a corner of society that won't have a huge impact from the application of machine learning. On a longer-term basis, quantum computing will be the only way to really get to the heart and the solution of those problems.
With this research of a cancer research and body research and genetic research, how soon do you think it's going to happen?
Well, it's happening now. I mean, we've been working with some startup companies on some machine learning applications for drug design. There's probably things within the next 3 or 4 years that will have had an impact in drug design that nobody will be talking about, but it will have in fact happened. So 10 years from now, you'll probably be being treated with some quantum computing design drug.
Stephen Hawking recently said that artificial intelligence could end mankind in 1,000 years. What do you think about that?
My view is that humans are going to be, whether 1,000 years or not, I don't know, but they'll certainly be around, because in addition to machines getting smarter, people are going to get smarter too. And if you look at all the research that they're doing to increase brain capacity, I mean, it may be that 15 years from now we have a little chip in our brain which gives us some quantum computing capability. The sooner that useless tasks get automated, I think the faster humans will be able to address serious problems. You know, from a social, political point of view, the next 10 years is going to be really quite dramatic. It means that governments are going to have to address that. They're going to have to dramatically change the educational process so that people are taught from an early age things that they need to be taught so that when they graduate, they can find tasks that they can do that are relevant to the society of the day.
How do you think it's going to affect our future? Is it going to change our everyday life?
I guess the way to answer that question, did fire change our life? Did the wheel change our life? You know, did the Industrial Revolution with steam engines change our life? And it's just that the impact of quantum computing will be bigger than any other. And that matched with machine learning, which is a software application of quantum computing, that will change our lives in ways we can't even anticipate at this point.
What message would you send to the younger entrepreneurs?
Well, I guess the message is study math and physics. I think as you look at the world as it is today, the problems that need solving are rooted in physics and math and chemistry and biology, but physics and math are the fundamental for everything. So if I were a parent with young children, I would be making sure that by the time they graduated from high school, they had at least 2 or 3 years of university math under their belt.